First Timothy chapter 6 verse 10. Brother Paul admonished Timothy. First Timothy 6:10. For the love of money is the root of all evil. While some coveted after, they have erred from the faith and pierced themselves through with many sorrows. Paul was talking to a preacher. He says they have erred from the faith. It doesn't mean you're going to hell when he says you erred. He says you're going to heaven as one who erred from the faith. Erred from the faith there is doctrine. It's not a loss of salvation. It means you have compromised doctrine. When a preacher begins to say, sow a seed to meet a need, he has erred from the faith. When a preacher begins to say, give me money to tap into my grace, he has erred from the faith. When a preacher begins to say, your offering will remove your suffering, he has erred from the faith. They have coveted after. They have erred from the faith. There are preachers who preach error because of money. A global preacher told me to my face on a platform, on a global platform where we are seated. I was a guest in America. We had to preach the whole world on TBN. TBN was where we were sitting on. Global TBN, not territorial TBN. The entire world were going to be seeing us at the same time on TBN. When TBN was TBN, we were on set, just about to roll the cameras on. He looked at me and said, Dr. Damina, the way you speak very convincingly. You have to raise money for us. We share it. I take 60, you take 40. I said, how do I do that? He said, just twist any scripture and just push it. Imagine the whole world giving to us. You will go home with millions of dollars. I looked at him and said, I don't know how to do it. He said, just any scripture. I said, sir, I don't know how to do it. I only know how to ask people to support your ministry, but I can't do beyond that. He was disappointed. He told me, can we go and have some granite? They switched the cameras off. That is how they excused me from that set, because I refused to twist scriptures to raise money. I refused to err from the faith. What shall it profit a man to gain all the monies in the world and lose his reward before Jesus? I've seen millionaires become poor. I've seen people that used to ride in the best private jets looking for food to eat. What is this life? What is this life? That you're planning to kill your brother because of a small profit in business. And I'm talking to somebody right now hearing the sound of my voice, maybe in this building or online, but I'm talking to somebody. What is this life? You're plotting to kill a brother because of a little profit in business. How long will it last? How much money? How much money? Many guys are in ministry for money. Paul said, I will not abuse my power. I will not even take an offering so that the ministry is not hindered. Sometimes preachers negotiate how much to be paid before they preach. How much are you going to pay me? Can you afford me? Can you afford me? Who are you? There's even a preacher I know that will ask you to send him your church bank statements. Let him see the balance before he will know whether he can come for you or not. I'm not telling you a story. I know him personally. Send your bank statements. Let me see the balance before I give you a date. That means the motivation. What will make him come and preach is the money. That will be burnt by fire because the motivation is wrong. I just came back from a trip. We went to preach. The preacher sent me an offering. We went with Pastor Philemon to preach. They sent me an offering. They sent Pastor Philemon an offering. I called Mama and said, I want to send the offering back to that church. I think the man needs the money more than me. I'm sending it back quickly. Pastor Philemon called me and said, Papa, I want to send you my own offering that they gave me. I said, no. Put it together with the one they gave me. Send it back to the pastor. Tell him we are giving it back to his ministry. We think he needs it more than us. And we send the money back to him. I paid my hotel on that trip. I took care of myself. The money they gave me, I gave it back to them. I'm not preaching for money. That's not my motivation. I'm preaching for Jesus. I want to see souls saved. I want to see believers equipped. And I want to see the glory of God fill the earth as the water covers the sea. I have my reward with Jesus. My eyes are in eternity. Now, I didn't do it for you to clap for me. That's not the first time I've done that. I'm just giving you that because that's a recent one that just happened a few days ago. It's not money that is motivating me. It's not money. But I said in the first service, as your pastor, I'm not on salary. You don't pay me no salary. I'm not preaching for money. I'm not preaching for a salary. I'm preaching because I believe that is the purpose of God for my life. And I don't want money to get in the way of me blessing you. I want you to be blessed. I have a reward at the judgment seat of Christ. That doesn't also mean that when a preacher preaches, you shouldn't honor him. You need to honor the preacher. That's the Bible. You honor. Let the preacher decide that he doesn't want. And if he wants, it is not wrong. But he must not negotiate it, because it's not a business. How much will you give me? 100,000. No, I will not come. Make it 250. Are you selling good? No, 140. No, make it 200. No. We cannot go beyond 150. If you make it 170, I will come. What a shame for the preaching of the gospel of Christ, the salvation that was given on the life of Christ himself. Paul says, from such preachers, withdraw yourself. Stay away from them. 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 5. 1 Timothy chapter 6 verse 5. Perverse disputings of men of corrupt minds and destitute of the truth, supposing that gain is godliness. From such, withdraw yourself. People that suppose that to make money is godly. People that suppose that the more money you get, the closer you are to God. He said they are corrupt. Withdraw from such people. I stopped listening to many preachers and I stopped hanging out with many preachers, because all they talk about is money. Money, money, money. A preacher told me, if you go for a program, there are three indicators that make the program a success. Three indicators. Number one, the crowd. Number two, the offering. The offering. The offering. Number three, the convenience. Flight, hotel, and the cars. Those are the indicators for a successful program. Can you imagine? The lives of the people are not even in the indicator. He told me. He said, before I preach for you, those indicators must be entered. Friends, there'll be surprises in heaven. When we see Jesus, many preachers you're clapping for will be crying. I kid you not. God, the yardstick of God's judgment is not your yardstick. You know your yardstick? He has three cars. He's driving in a limousine. He has protocol, bodyguard. Soldiers and police are protecting him. The man of God, if you see his suit and shoe, they are too expensive. That is your own yardstick for a man of God. But that is also the yardstick for a Hollywood star. Yeah. That's a yardstick for the secular. See the carnality in the church? If a pastor wears an old suit with old shoes, rides a bicycle, they say he's not anointed. See the carnality in the church? Anointed men are the ones that carry big cars. So because of that, young boys that should be in ministry out of love for God, they now develop a greed, because you have put them under pressure that they are not called by God if they don't drive big cars. So they will go and meet native doctor and collect something and put in their mouth. When they talk, you just like, you are hypnotized. I see. What are they seeing? They have washed their eye with diabolical powers. See, I'm right now, I'm in your village. How can a man of God be in your village when he's in the city? What are you doing in the village? Designed for the city, tied in the village. Do you rate people based on how much they have? James said, you mustn't treat people according to their money. Look at what God said to the church, one of the churches in Asia. Revelation chapter 3 verse 17. Revelation chapter 3 verse number 17. Because thou sayest, I am rich and increased with goods and have need of nothing, and knowest not that thou art wretched and miserable and poor and blind and naked. You think you have money. You have 100 million naira. You have 500 million naira. But you are naked. You are blind. You are empty. You are poor. You are wretched. Before God, you are not up to one penny. Where it matters, you are nothing. You are only something among the mundane. So you say you are rich. You say you are rich. You say you are increased with goods. But God say, look, you are poor. You are blind. You don't have anything where God is concerned. Never put money first. When you are looking for a job, don't look at the salary. Find out, does God want me in this place? If God wants you there, even if the salary is not good enough, go there. Because where the will of God is for your life, that's where peace is. That's where safety is. That's where security is. And that's where the blessing is.